Hi guys, Omar here. Today we are checking if a 3D FX Voodoo 2 card can work with modern hardware. And more than that, can we get it running in Windows 11? Now that sounds impossible because of course we would need 64-bit drivers. But believe it or not, a long time ago someone actually wrote 64-bit drivers for the original Voodoo cards, and we're going to put them to test. But first, we have to answer a question. One of my subscribers asked if the StarTech enclosure I showed here before would work with a Voodoo 2, a Voodoo 3, or basically any PCIe video card. At first, I just replied, yeah, it should work, I don't see why not. But as it turns out, things are not that simple. Now, unlike the original Voodoo, which doesn't play nice with faster CPUs, usually over 1 GHz, the Voodoo 2 doesn't have that limitation, so in theory it should come down to having the right drivers and of course being able to connect the Voodoo 2 to the system somehow. A regular PCI Express to PCI adapter will get the job done, but these aren't practical with full-size cards like the Voodoo 2, because the extra height blocks access to the Voodoo 2's VGA output. Sure, we could use an extension cable to mount the card vertically, and some newer cases support that, but it's more practical to use an external PCI enclosure, like this full-length StarTech model. Now, the model I have only handles half-length cards, and the Voodoo 2 is a bit too large, so I had to move the main board outside the enclosure, which was actually quite easy to do. With everything connected, I booted straight into Windows 98. Here we don't have to worry about the operating system getting in the way, because the Voodoo driver is allowed to talk directly to the card. That means there are fewer things that can go wrong, and everything was fine. The card showed up, the drivers installed without any issues, and yes, now we have a Voodoo 2 running in Windows 98 on an AM5 PC with a Ryzen 9 9900X CPU. Pretty cool if you ask me. I initially used the custom FastVoodoo drivers, these were released back in 2004, but to my surprise the final official 3DFX reference drivers scored better in Quake 2. And speaking of frames, a Voodoo 2 card is bottlenecked by the CPU at just around 500 MHz. A faster CPU has to wait for the Voodoo 2 card to finish its business, so we basically get the same results whether we have a Pentium III or this Ryzen 9 clocked at 4.4 GHz, which by the way scored 62.2 FPS in Quake 2 at 800x600, the go-to resolution for a single Voodoo 2. Anyway, considering our PCI configuration, getting slightly over 60 FPS is a perfect score, the best a Voodoo 2 can deliver at stock speeds. Also, when we run the 3D Mark 2001 benchmark, the same Ryzen 9 CPU, we're getting a pretty good score at 640x480. 868 points, it's a very high score for a single Voodoo 2 card, otherwise not exactly great by 2001 standards. However, if we try to use a standalone video card, it's a completely different story. Initially, we can boot and even install drivers, but the system just isn't stable. I tried both an S3 Verge and a Voodoo 3, and in both cases, the system would freeze randomly. So it looks like we can't use the separate video cards with the setup. The problem seems to be the 3-foot DVI cable that transfers the signal between the enclosure and the PCI Express bus, but at the same time it adds some latency. Cards like the Voodoo 3 and the S3 Verge are PCI bus masters. They aggressively take control of the bus to transfer data, but with that long cable, the responses come back too slowly, so the card gets stuck in an endless retry loop and freezes the entire system. The Voodoo 2 works fine because it doesn't do any bus mastering, it simply responds to commands from the CPU, rather than trying to control the bus itself, which makes it more tolerant of latency issues. Anyway, to confirm this, I just need to test with a shorter DVI cable, which I don't have it right now. Next, I tried the Voodoo 2 in Windows 10, the 32-bit edition, which you know is the last 32-bit Windows ever. I used the well-maintained drivers from Cool Smoky. I tested them on Windows 7 a while ago, and sure enough, they worked perfectly fine on Windows 10. But that was the easy part. The real challenge was getting this card to run on the 64-bit editions of Windows, like Windows 10 or 11. This brings us back to the project I mentioned in the beginning. So, in late 2006, a developer named Ryan Nunn, aka Colourless, pulled off something incredible. He wrote an experimental 64-bit Windows driver for the original 3DFX Voodoo cards. This was a huge deal considering how the Windows NT architecture works. And let's not forget, this is the very foundation of all modern Windows. Unlike Windows 9X, where drivers could talk to hardware directly, NT locks this away for security and stability. So the original 3DFX Glide drivers were actually user mode programs that needed special kernel level services to access the hardware. So what Colourless did was basically to hack the original Windows NT 4 drivers to figure out how they worked, and then he rebuilt the whole system for 64-bit Windows XP. He created a new kernel driver that acts like a translator, letting the original 3DFX DLLs, completely unmodified, think they're talking to the old Windows NT kernel, while in reality they're communicating with his new 64-bit driver. And guess what? The driver installed just fine in Windows 10 64-bit, except it didn't work. Switching to Glide rendering ends with mapmem return an error trying to map memory. This is actually a good thing, as it means the driver is working, but the Glide DLLs are having problems. Luckily, this problem was fixed even before the driver was released. We just need to use some fixed Glide DLLs that won't return this error. This requires a fix originally made for XP. When its installer runs, it tries to put the 32-bit Glide DLLs into System32, but Windows automatically redirects them to the SysWow64 folder. Once we have the files in place, we're good to go. So yes, now we had successfully tricked Windows 10 64-bit into running a Voodoo 2. Now, what about Windows 11? Well, the procedure should be exactly the same. First, we of course have to disable driver signature enforcement and use the exact same drivers originally meant for XP-X64, as they seem to be universal for all 64-bit Windows editions. And indeed, the drivers installed. I was fully expecting the classic mapmem error, but instead I got a different one. This time it suggested that the Voodoo 2 wasn't detected, or maybe the driver wasn't loaded. That's why my first fix was to restart the service that handles the Voodoo cards, the FX Voodoo Sys driver, but nothing changed. The next step was to try the other PCI slot on this X470 motherboard, and guess what? The Voodoo 2 returned the mapmem error, which of course is a good thing. Now we know the drill. I simply replaced the Glide DLLs, and yes, we now have a 3D accelerator from 1998 using a driver that relies on services written for Windows NT from 1996, successfully running in Windows 11 23H2. It's not the very latest build, but it's pretty close. Alright, I know, so far I haven't addressed the elephant in the room. What about SLI, the Voodoo 2's killer feature? So back in 1998, the Voodoo 2 was the fastest 3D accelerator, but if you had the money, it could run two cards together, with each one rendering half the screen. This typically gave anywhere from 50 to 80% more frames, depending on the game, and it was the ultimate gaming setup. Nothing else could touch it. So does SLI work in a modern setup? Well, not really. It didn't work on the M4 configuration at all. On the M5 build running Windows 98, the second card was somehow detected and I even managed to get Quake 2 running. It worked for a few seconds before it crashed. Now, could it be the drivers, the PCIe to PCI bridge chip, or maybe the board can't handle the sustained load of two Voodoo 2 cards? It's hard to tell, but there is another factor. My other Voodoo 2 has an issue with one of its TMUs. It's still usable solo, but renders a lot of glitchy stuff on the screen. Even with that, my hunch is that SLI itself should still work. And that's exactly why I put together a period correct build with a Pentium II 350 and a SOYO 440BX motherboard, a configuration that has no excuse not to run two Voodoos in SLI. I went of course with Windows 98, running from a SATA drive with the help of that same VIA6421 PCIe to SATA adapter I've shown you way too many times. And speaking of Windows 98, if you really want to run a Voodoo 2 on modern hardware, this is the way to go. The native driver is faster and many classic 3DFX titles that just work in Windows 98 either won't run on Windows 10 or 11 or require a lot of tinkering to get them started. So back to our question, does SLI work even with a partially broken Voodoo 2? Well, yes it does, and the glitches were gracefully transferred into the SLI setup. The frame rate is definitely higher, though let's not forget our Pentium 2 is bottlenecking the whole thing. So I guess that's it for today, I hope you enjoyed the video. While diagnosing the faulty Voodoo 2, I asked for help from Daniel from SDZ-Mods. You know, the guy who makes those crazy custom 3DFX cards. He told me to send the card over for a fix. In the meantime, he's done it again, this time with a low-profile Voodoo 3 PCI card. I hope I can get my hands on that beauty soon. Now, thanks for watching, folks. More soon.